I'm Tom from Do-It-Yourself Home Automation, and this is a look at assembling the 2 gallon poultry waterer from Rentacoop. So as I've shown in another video, this is a new solution I'm testing for water for my chickens in their small coop. It comes with these little watering cups, and it has a pre-drilled hole that we're going to use to install one of those. So the first step, just take the lid off of the top here. It's a nice solid plastic container. Looks like it actually has multiple pre-drilled holes, so I'll have to put at least two of these in, and I think it's designed to actually go in the corner of the coop so that they can potentially drink from either side. So I'm going to go ahead and open up one of these chicken waterers, and then we'll see how it goes in. Okay, so here's the actual watering cup. You can see it's got a little O-ring here, this threaded piece, and then it's got this little nut on here. So I'm going to unscrew this first. And it's really simple, just unscrewing here like you would any other nut. And I'm going to pause and finish that. Okay, so that's off. Here's the threaded piece, and there's the hole. And I'm just going to insert this into the hole, and then I'm going to screw the other piece in from the inside of the bucket. Okay, so here's that inserted. It's a nice tight fit. You can see that O-ring that's going to create a watertight seal is nice and flush against the side. And then on the inside, this is protruding in. So I'm going to take that nut and I'm just going to screw it in here until it's hand tight. Okay, so that's one waterer there. Now I'm going to install the other one on the other side here in the same way. Okay, so here this is with both of these on. Now I'm just going to put the lid back on top and then just the other way around. And I'll put that on, and then let's try to set it up in the coop. Okay, so here's the edge of my Tonkala coop. This is my pretty small coop, and you can see I just removed the old water, and it was actually leaking a bit on the ground there, so I'll have to clean that out. But in any event, here's the corner I'm going to be putting it into. And in order to have those waterers up off the ground, you need to kind of raise the height a little bit. So one option is using a chain and hanging it from the top of the coop, but the top of my coop is actually plastic here. So I'm gonna put this in and raise it up off the ground like that. I think ideally I would probably use like a brick or something that's gonna be harder for the chickens to knock over, but let's start with this and see how it goes. Okay, so here it is, a little bit of a tight squeeze. You can see I'll have to put this in and then I'll fill it once it's in there. Obviously, I'm not gonna be able to fill it when I'm holding it like this, but I'm gonna go ahead and put this in and just situate it over in the corner here. And then I'm gonna pause and get that really settled. Okay, so there it is. You can see these little nipple waterers are nicely off of the ground. Hopefully they're not gonna get anything kicked into them. It does take up a fair amount of real estate in the corner here. It kind of blocks the ramp a bit, but you know, chickens are pretty resourceful. I think they'll find a way to get in there. And then the final step is just to fill it up with water. So I'll use probably a gallon jug and pour water in there. And I'm gonna do that, and we'll take a look in another video at how this actually works as a waterer. But that's how I'm setting it up and then putting it into the coop. If you wanna see how my chickens like it and actually how it works, as a waterer with water in it, please subscribe to my channel, follow along here. If you found this helpful in any way, please subscribe, it really helps.